And joining us this morning on Hot Copy, our first live guest after 2 years, live from the ABS-CBN newsroom, we have with us this morning, Senator Raffy Tulfo. Senator Tulfo, magandang umaga sa iyo. Ikaw ang kumbaga una naming, ikaw binyag. Bininyagan mo yung aming studio after the pandemic.
I'm very flattered. Salamat. Thank you for having me.
All right, let's start first. The transition from a broadcast journalist to the Senate, although you are not the first to make that transition.
Right.
It's been 100 days.
Okay.
What have you learned so far? What's it like for you? What challenges did you face?
Oh yeah, that's a good question. Medyo merong malaking adjustment that I have to make because as a broadcaster doing public service for so many years, I can solve a case na inilalapit sa akin in hours, days, or in just a matter of a week. Dito kasi meron tinatawag na process na I have to observe. So naninibago ako doon. So meron tinatawag na red tape, kailangan tatawag ka rito, tatawag doon. But it's okay. But the thing is very important to me now is I do have the understanding na kailangan dumaan ka pa rin sa proseso, although I want things done the best way I want it. Pero again, may proseso.
You supported President Marcos during the campaign. He just arrived from the ASEAN summit.
Mm-hmm.
Let me ask you first. For now, there's still no code of conduct coming from China. Mm-hmm. What do you make of that?
Well, you're right. I supported President BBM and I'm still supporting him. And lahat ng mga decisions na gagawin niya, I would support. And of course, we really need to support our president kasi his success will be the success of the country. So whatever it is that he decides for the good of the country, it is for the good of everybody.
Okay. All right. So the code of conduct, I mean, even coming from former President Duterte, China has, of course, they've taken a while. They've dragged their feet when it comes to the code of conduct with the South China Sea. Right. What action should the country take?
Well, we have to continue with diplomacy, just like what Duterte has been saying all along. Hindi naman natin pwedeng gawin yung gusto natin, kahit napipilitin natin. China would only tell us na itong paper na we get from the Hague decision, pwede naman nilang punitin yon. So diplomacy, that's the only way to do it. That's the best way I see na to do it, to talk to them, to sit in a bargaining table and see if we can come up with something na para both sides ay makapag-agree into something.
Now, one of the bigger challenges of this administration today, right now, would be inflation.
Yes.
Yes, unemployment, the numbers have decreased, which is good. But then we were coming also from the challenge of the pandemic.
Right.
But when it comes to inflation, are you satisfied with the actions this administration has taken? Or what would you want them to do?
Okay. Yeah, we see the rise of inflation since 2008. It's all-time high from 6-something. Now we're at 7.7, I think. Although the government is doing everything na para ma-address yung problema. Kaya lang, it's something na beyond our control, tulad yung nangyari sa Ukraine and Russia, global recession. But we have to do more. Well, nakakatulong po yung mga remittances ng ating OFWs. But we have to raise our export. And then at the same time, siguro yung direct foreign investment, kailang pumasok pa yan para ma-address yung inflation.
Okay, let's talk about our OFWs. You've been very active in the budget deliberations and you've been very passionate about our OFWs, okay? So I know that last night the Senate approved the budget of the Migrant Workers Department.
Right.
It's now at 17 billion pesos. Tama ba ito, Senator?
Almost 17 billion.
In total pala yun, no?
Yeah. They requested 28.2 billion. Approved ng DBM was 15.2.
Okay.
So medyo pumalag ako. Sabi ko, bakit yung DBM slash ng slash, hindi nila naiintindihan kung ano talaga yung pangangailangan ng isang departamento such as the OFWs. So dahil sa aking pangungulit sa kanila, nabigyan naman ng increase ng almost a billion yung ating yung DMW and especially dun sa OWA because OWA was requesting for yung capital outlay para pagbili ng mga sasakyan and the operational expenses, what have you. Inislas to zero.
Oh, let's talk about that.
Nagalit ako doon.
Because you scolded the DBM in the Senate and you said you're acting like God. Were
exactly.
you out of place doing that?
No, I wasn't. Well, if I was for some people, then I apologize. Pero I was just doing what I have to do. Kasi ako nakita ko yung needs ng mga OFWs. That's why I asked those people from the DBM, what made you an expert para sa isang department para to make a decision na ito yung bagay lamang para sa inyo. Another thing, Karen, medyo naglay sila eh. They said they requested from OWA to send documents to justify their request for the capital outlay. Mm. And OWA said they did send them those documents. Pero sabi ng DBM, hindi raw. So sabi ko, sino nagsinungaling sa inyo? OWA o DBM? Mm. And they cannot answer that. So anyway, sa paungulit ko, finally, they've decided na, sige, I'll give them 100 million para lang siguro makita na talagang pinagbigyan ako.
Baon.
So and I'm happy. DBM, thank you very much.
So bumalik ang capital outlay ng OWA, the 100 million is back?
Actually, it's not. It's not that yun ang hindi exact amount na binigyan nila. At least nagbigay, kaysa naman zero.
Okay. I wanted to ask you, because what I have here right now, so the final budget of the DMW is at 17 billion,
okay.
where 4.3 billion goes to the office of the secretary,
right.
Secretary Ople, and right. 11.7 billion goes to the OWA. Tama
right.
ba ito?
Right, right.
And yeah. what changes in the OWA with the budget of 11.7 billion?
Well, I don't have the exact figures
Uh-oh.
Now, pero what I'm really very happy about is yung from zero dun sa capital outlay, nabigyan ng 100 million. Mm-hmm. So just remember, yung zero to 100 million, malaking pera yon. Yung 100 million, saan gagamitin yon? It will be used for purchase of new vehicles kasi yeah. nga, hindi alam ng mga taga DBM na yung mga sasakyan na ginagamit ng OWAP to fetch and
para nirerenta pa.
Nirerenta.
Mahal yun.
Exactly. And then sira-sira pa yung mga sasakyan na. So I said it's about time siguro magbili ng mga bagong sasakyan and then bagong mga kagamitan para naman mag-effective yung OWA sa pagtulong doon sa mga OFWs na dumarating at hinahatid nila doon sa kanilang mga bahay sa probinsya.
Okay. Another thing that was discovered and revealed in the Senate hearings, which I found quite alarming, was the OFW hospital in Mabalacat, Pampanga. There was an approval of 250 million to build that hospital.
Right.
But then apparently, I think the DBM only approved in the past 13 million. What is the future of that hospital now?
Well, it's in the dark, actually. Thank you for bringing that up. In fact, nagreklamo nga yung DMW na meron na mga properties mm-hmm. or land na that was donated to DMW para magtayo ng mga hospitals
yeah.
or mga offices for the use of DMW for the purpose na para pakinabangan ng mga taga-OWA. Pero tinurn down ng DBM dahil wala raw budget, wala raw justification. And yet, DMWs and OWAs been telling na palagi kami nagpapadala ng mga documents to justify yung aming request. But again, it fell on deaf ears.
Okay. But we are talking of limited funding, Senator. So ang tanong ng ilan is, why have you been silent on the confidential funds of three major offices right now, that confidential funds that have been ballooning? Let's
okay.
start with this. 9.3 billion pesos in confidential funds
mm-hmm.
for the 2023 budget.
Okay.
You have 500 million going to the office of the vice president,
okay.
which it didn't have before.
Okay.
150 million going to the DepEd, which it didn't have before.
Okay.
And 19 million going to the office of the solicitor general, which it didn't have before.
Okay, you're right. In fact, napag-usapan namin yan ng mga kapwa ko senador. May mga mm-hmm. nagke-question, meron naman nag-agree. For me, I'll stay neutral. I still have to look into it. I still have to investigate, see if they really need it. For the meantime, ang gusto ko lang kasing sabihin dito, para sa atin, for everybody and for me, we have to protect the welfare of the children. Alam mo yung nangyari sa Amerika, diba? Yung mga bata palagi nagiging victims pagdating sa mga random shooting, yung dito sa atin, ito, recorded to, marami mga pushers na nagtitinda ng mga drugs sa paligid ng mga eskwelahan. So maybe those confidential funds can be used to track down who are those people, you know, trying to take advantage of
but from the DepEd security. The DepEd confidential funds?
Yeah, it can be used. Siguro, pwedeng gamitin para i-track down sino itong mga pusher, sino itong mga drug lords na nagbebenta ng mga drugs sa paligid ng eskwelahan, and then
But shouldn't the PNP be doing that? Well, I mean, shouldn't the PDEA be doing that?
The PNP and PDEA is already overwhelmed as it is. So, mas maganda siguro kung merong sarili ang isang departamento to do their intelligence networking as opposed to mag-aasa na lang sa PNP, sa PDEA. So, everybody's been umaasa na lang dun sa dalawang agencies na yun. So, it will be best kung DepEd, magkaroon silang sariling intelligence networking para ma-solving issue na yun. But I'm not saying that I'm totally in favor of that.
Okay. You are not saying you're totally in favor. What about the 500 million pesos confidential and intelligence funds for the office of the vice president?
Well, that is something that has to be studied for me. So why does she need that big amount as confidential fund? Maybe she has a reason and she has to justify that. Maybe we have to monitor the spending, how it's going to be spent. Siguro, titingnan yung menu dun sa confidential funds. Saan ba gagamitin yun? Iyan ba'y pasok doon sa tinatawag na allowed sa menu na ina-allow na amount for that confidential fund and how it's going to be spent?
Oo. Taon-taon lumalaki rin ang confidential fund ng Pangulo. Coming from, if we move many years back, I remember a confidential fund of 500 million. Now it's escalated to, more than, I believe, 7 billion already at this point. If my numbers are wrong, I could be corrected for this. But what do you make of the ballooning confidential funds of the office of the president?
Siguro sabi nila inflation. No, I'm just kidding. Again, I'm not an expert when it comes to trying to determine the needs of a certain department, so much so pagdating sa office of the president. Mm-hmm. And so ayoko maging expert pagdating dyan. And they have to explain that to the people. Mas maganda kung magagaling sa kanila to explain directly to the people, to the media, kung bakit that's the big amount that they're requesting is justifiable para maging confidential fund for this for a certain year.
And is this one of the difficulties that Senator Raffy Tulfo faces? Because as a broadcaster, all your years as a broadcaster, kilala kang matapang. Ang media man tumitira. In fact, a media man is known to question and criticize government. And now as a senator, you wear a different hat. You are with a majority.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
So is it harder for you?
Well, not really, because I'm an independent kasi ako. Wala naman ako. I don't belong to any party, so I don't owe anybody a favor or utang na loob, so to speak. So I can say what I want to say. But the thing is, sometimes nakikita ko naman para sa ikabubuti na lahat, para mapabilis yung isang proseso, then I'm in the majority, and then later on, mapapakinabangan ko naman yan kung meron akong gusto ipasa ng mga batas o resolusyon. Being in the majority, wala masyadong question.
Okay. Now, there will your biggest concern about the budget, because you've been quite active, you've called out the DBM twice.
Yes.
One on the OWA, I have to say the other one on the DOJ.
Yes.
The slashing of the budget on the DOJ, and thrice pala.
Particularly the NBI.
You've even given DTI Secretary Pascual a difficult time in the hearing.
I did. Pero okay na kami, bati na kami.
Oh, okay. What was that all about? Let's start with Secretary Pascual. You also had critics,
yes,
right? I'm sure you saw critics saying, why did Senator Raffy Tulfo concentrate on the sodium content of the noodles, considering Pascual came for a whole other set? There was a whole agenda he had prepared to present to all of you.
The whole agenda, hindi ba importante yung kalusugan ng mga kabataan, kalusugan ng mamamayang Pilipino? Just remember, every month, like 1 million Filipinos ay nagkakasakit nagkakaroon ng kidney problems. Mm-hmm. And ano yung cause ng kidney problems? Too much sodium. Saan nagagaling too much sodium? Sa food, especially yung mga mahihirap. Sino bang kumakain nitong cup noodles? Ito yung mga mahihirap because these are the only food that they can afford to buy. And yet, hindi natin inaalagaan yung kanilang kalusugan. Mm-hmm. And we put so much sodium in dun sa cup noodles. Eh, kung 3 times a day sila kumakain, ang allowable lang ata is 2,000 milligrams per day. Eh, some of them eat that 3 times a day. Meron yung isang cup noodles na 1,900 ang sodium content. So if someone eats that 3 times a day, just imagine, that's almost 6,000. Mm-hmm. Plus, kuminsan nagtutoyo pa sila, nag-aasin, nagbabagoong. That's the reason why, kung titignan mo yung data sa National Kidney Center, may kita mo na umaakyat, hindi bumababa, yung mga Pilipino nagkakasakit sa kidney. Sa
and some critics have asked, why did Senator Raffy Tulfo bring that up with the Trade Secretary instead of the Health Secretary?
Because at that time, hindi ako naka-attend sa DOH. I mean, sorry. When I attended sa DOH, naka-focus naman ako dun sa mga medisina na nabubulok, na nag-expire, na napabayaan nila. Na expired, and we're talking about billions and billions of pesos. Doon ako nag-focus. Mm-hmm. And at the same time, gusto ko malaman kung yung for so many years na palaging may mga gamot na expired, kung meron na bang nakasuhan. So,
Iba yun.
Oo. Then, here comes the DTI. Mm-hmm. Na alam ko sila yung nagmamonitor sa prices and sa mga foods na binibenta sa mga groceries. So, they're responsible for the welfare of the consumer. So, therefore, if they're responsible for the consumer, yung binibili mga consumer, bakit hindi nila tinututukan yung mga pagkain na binibenta dyan sa market? And what really pisses me off, Karen, ayoko kasi yung upbringing ko as a media man for so many years. If someone comes to me, I don't tell people na, hey, hindi sa akin yan. Ipasa mo yan doon, ipasa mo yan dito. Hindi. I do something na para mahanapan ko ng solution, kung kinakailangan ako na mismo ang lalapit doon sa mga iba't-ibang agency para ma-solve yung problem. What the DTI did was, nagtuturoan para mga Poncio Pilato naghugas ng kamay. Sabi ko, you should have the decency na para sabihin, sige, we will refer that to the proper agency, we'll look into that, etc. Fortunately, and I would like to thank the DTI, sumulat sila sa, I think, DOH and FDA, saying na, as per my complaint, please check yung contents ng mga noodles, kung anong pwedeng magawa natin para ma-address ng issue na ito.
Does a law need to be passed?
Yes.
For that kind of change?
Yes, siguro sa doon sa labeling.
Is that right? Okay.
Yeah, for me, kasi para magkaroon naman siguro ng choice yung mga consumer. Halimbawa, i-label mo na parang red, masyado mataas, i-label mo ng green, medyo okay, and then yellow, medyo-medyo lang, gano'n.
Or to put a maximum sodium content, because I know there's a European country that actually banned our noodles because of the sodium content.
There is. Pero yeah, papalag naman yung mga manufacturer ng mga cup noodles. And papalag din naman siguro yung mga consumer. Kasi alam mo naman, mga Pilipino mahilig sa maalat. Kaya nga marami nagkakasakit sa kidney, nagkakaproblema sa kidney. So I think the best is maglalagay tayo ng label na papakita natin sa mga Pilipino na ito, masyado mataas ang sodium nitong si cup noodles A, si cup noodles B, okay lang, si cup noodles C, walang problema kasi sodium dito, pero hindi naman maalat. So magkakaroon ng choice yung mga tao.
Okay, and you're not scared of the effect on this on you? I mean, I know Senator Cynthia Villar at one point said that only rice should stop because it's a contributor to diabetes, and she was heavily criticized for that. And now you're calling the attention of something that's worth calling the attention to, but there might be a kind of drawback.
Well, I agree with Senator Villar na dapat ipagbawal yung unli rice. Talagang that would cause diabetes to many people. And in my case, no, hindi ako takot. Kasi ang focus ko sa ang intention ko is para to monitor and to make sure na maging maayos at malusog yung ating mga kababayan para hindi sila magkakasakit sa kidney stone. Mm-hmm. So what's wrong with that? So kung may mga galit sa akin as a result of that, ayaw nila maging malusog yung mga kababayan natin, so be it. Mm-hmm. Ibas nila ko hanggang langit. I don't care. What I care about is the health and well-being of the Filipino people.